Looks like they're clearing this out.
Okay.
Well, Erica, we have seen a few ambulances leave. We're not sure if they actually had any of the people who are injured in this incident in them, but a few ambulances did leave a short time ago. We've seen more law enforcement arrive since that confirmation came out from Aurora Police that the shooter was in custody. But still, as you can see from this live picture, there are a number of ambulances that remain here on the scene, obviously standing by so that they can assist anyone else who might have been injured in this incident. A lot of neighbors are still very curious, you know, standing by, looking at what's going on. You can maybe see from these pictures, some of these officers still have their weapons out, even though the word has spread that the shooter was apprehended. They're not taking any chances, obviously, still keeping those weapons at the ready in case they're needed, in case perhaps there's more than one shooter. We've not had any indication of that. All of the initial reports said it was an active shooter, as in one person, but again, law enforcement are just following up on everything that they can. Multiple sources reporting to us that there are a number of injuries. We do not know the extent of those injuries at this time. And we were also told by sources that some of those injured are, in fact, law enforcement. At one point, several officers, according to sources, were pinned down and they were able to be rescued. But we don't know the extent of those officers' injuries. Rob, Erica.
I can get the cart, yeah, I can.
Thank you. No
problem.
Well, Eric, I can tell you that since the news came out that the shooter had been apprehended, you can tell that the level of concern out here has dropped a bit. There's not as many officers with their guns drawn. We've seen some sharing the information and updates. When we first arrived on scene, almost every member of law enforcement had their gun out, drawn, and at the ready. There are still SWAT team members around here in full gear, helmets and cameras, but it does seem like everyone is taking a step back and they're processing it. We did see some activity earlier with a number of SWAT team members going into the building. As Ross Rice had touched on, this is normal. They need to make sure that the building is clear and that there are no other people involved in this active shooting, and that the one person they have in custody is in fact the only person that they're looking for. So right now we did see that group of SWAT team members head into the building. Right now there's also a large group of law enforcement, as you can see from this live picture, gathered around a command center van. Obviously you can see the different uniforms and understand how many different law enforcement agencies answered this call for help, because initially, as Brad was mentioning, we got the reports of officers being down, officers injured, and that initiated a massive response from law enforcement throughout this area. Pretty much every suburban first responder from the fire departments and police are on scene. Also, all of the different sheriff's departments are all here. State police are out here. We've seen ATF. Everyone is out here trying to assist Aurora police with this incident.